Hi everyone, in this video, we'll upgrade Zabbix server to the latest version Zabbix 7.4. This update brings major improvements in performance, security and user interface. First, we need to make sure that there's an active and running Zabbix server. The upgrade will be performed directly on the existing system. Next, check which operating system version your server is running. As you can see, I'm using Ubuntu 22.04 LTS. Next, check which version of Zabbix your system is currently running. My Zabbix server is currently running version 7.0. Next, let's check the name of the database used by Zabbix. This is the name of my database. Yours might be different, so make sure to remember the exact name for the backup step. Before upgrading, we need to back up the Zabbix-related configuration files, so in case anything goes wrong, we can easily restore the system. First, let's create a folder to store the configuration files. This will help keep our backups organized and easy to manage. Next, let's back up the Zabbix configuration files and save them into the folders we just created. I've already prepared a file with all the necessary commands and detailed explanations, so I'll go through them quickly here to save time. Now let's run these commands one by one. Make sure to follow each step carefully to keep everything running smoothly. For this command, make sure to replace it with your actual database name. We already identified it in an earlier step. Now, enter your MySQL root password when prompted. To be safe, double-check the backup files to make sure everything important has been saved before we proceed with the upgrade. All set! Let's start the upgrade process now. First, we'll remove the old Zabbix release package from the system to make room for the new repository. Next, let's download the latest Zabbix release package from the official Zabbix website. Make sure to select the version that matches your operating system. Once the download is complete, we'll install the new Zabbix release package using dpkg-i and then update the package list with apt-update. Next, before we upgrade, we need to stop the Zabbix server and Zabbix agent services to make sure the upgrade process runs safely and without any conflicts. All right, everything is ready. Now let's upgrade the Zabbix server, web frontend, and all related components. At this point, the system might ask if you want to replace the existing configuration files. Type N to keep your current config so you don't lose your existing settings. All right, the Zabbix server upgrade is complete. Now let's verify that Zabbix server has been upgraded to the correct version. Alright, Zabbix has been successfully upgraded to version 7.4. Now, restart the Zabbix server and Zabbix agent services on your system to apply the changes after the upgrade. Next, let's check the status of the Zabbix server service to make sure it's running properly after the upgrade. If the status shows active running, it means Zabbix server is running normally and the upgrade was successful. Next, let's access the Zabbix web GUI to confirm that the system is working properly and the version has been successfully upgraded. It looks like we forgot to restart the Apache service, so the web interface hasn't picked up the new configuration yet. Let's restart Apache now to apply the changes. Alright, so everything is working well after the upgrade. The Zabbix server, web GUI, and all related components are running smoothly. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to stay updated with more awesome sysadmin content. See you in the next video.